Srimati Vijila ji, Vijila Sathyananth.
Thank you, Deputy Chairman sir. It is a privilege for me to speak on this very important bill. As we are supporting the bill, I would like to bring to your this August House a few apprehensions and suggestions that our dynamic Home Minister may take it into account, especially that has been given by our All India Anna Dravida Munnetra Kalham Supremo, our great leader, Dr. Purachi Thalavi Amma. She asserted that she would take continuous steps to attain a separate homeland for Tamils in Sri Lanka and demanded the centre to grant dual citizenship for refugees from the island nation living in our state. She once said, and I quote, we will urge the central government to confer dual citizenship on Sri Lankan Tamils living here so that they can easily get job opportunities, unquote. So she always fought for enabling Sri Lankan Tamils to live with full freedom and self-respect and to attain a separate elam that her government and personally she will continuously take valuable steps to bring forth. These are the people who were born to refugees and raised in this state. Some were born here for the refugees and they were living in the state. When the central government tried to repatriate them, the then central government, it was opposed by my government. That is, Amma said, my government opposed it. So the then central government. So she strongly stressed that her party, that is the All India Anna Dravida Munnetra Kalagam, policy was that any repatriation would be voluntary and based on the choice of refugees. After the situation in Sri Lanka, including the security aspects, changes fully, better nation, better livelihood, self-respect, then the policy will change. So she recalled that the Tamil Nadu Assembly has passed several resolutions on the Sri Lankan issue moved by her. And the Madurai bench of the Madras High Court agreed that granting citizenship was within the exclusive executive domain of the centre. According to the records available with the Department of Rehabilitation of the State of Tamil Nadu, only 4,60,000 people have arrived in India and have registered themselves as repatriated Indian citizens from Sri Lanka. Other than refugee cards issued at the time of entry into the country, the Tamils do not have any document in support of their status. Now they are considered as stateless Indian origin Tamils from Sri Lanka, and the stateless Indian origin Tamils from Sri Lanka are kept together with the Sri Lankan Tamil refugees in the state organized camps in Tamil Nadu. They have no state identification and they are considered as Sri Lankan citizens. Their repeated claims for Indian citizenship were refused as on legal grounds as illegal migrants. They are not illegal migrants. There are 20,000 and more, nearly 90% of them are born in India to these refugees. Most of these people are living in India for more than 25 years, maybe 30 years. About 90% of the population belong to the Hindu religion. So as these Sri Lankan refugees fulfill all the required criteria, other than they are mentioned as illegal migrants, keeping in mind the experience of their prosecution by the refugees and the status of being persons of Indian origin, I plead to our Honorable Home Minister, kindly you include and consider that the Citizenship Bill also take into account the Sri Lankan refugees and give them Indian citizenship. Thank you. And with these words, I support this
Thank
bill.
Thank you.
இந்த வீடியோ உங்களுக்கு பிடிச்சிருந்தா please like and share பண்ணுங்க. மறக்காம எங்க சேனலை subscribe பண்ணுங்க.